We shall continue with the questions on correlation and regression. So question number 4, find the lines of regression and hence find the coefficient of correlation for the following data. A table of x and y values are given. Altogether there are 10 pair of x and y values. So n will be equal to 10. Here the first part of the question is find the lines of regression and hence find the coefficient of correlation. So first you need to find equation of the regression lines. Using that you have to find the coefficient of correlation r. So to find the equation of the regression line, a regression line of y is capital letter y equal to summation capital letter xy divided by summation x square into capital letter x, where capital letter x is x minus x bar, capital letter y is y minus y bar. So x bar means it is actually the mean of x values, which is summation sigma x by n or 7. Y bar is mean of y value, which is 15. So capital letter x will be x minus 7, capital letter y is y minus 15. Similarly, the regression line of x on y is capital letter x is equal to summation xy divided by summation y square into capital letter y. Now using the values of x and y given in the question, using the small letter x values, you need to calculate capital letter x values, which is x minus 7. Once you get all capital letter x values, square it and get all the possible values of capital letter x square. Therefore, the sum summation x square, which will be 204. Similarly, for each of that 10 y values given in the question, you have to calculate capital letter y values using capital letter y equal to small letter y minus 15. Once you get all that capital letter y values, square it and get capital letter y square values. At the bottom of the table, summation capital letter y squares, adding all the values of y square, summation y square will be 818. Then look at that column headed by capital letter X and the column headed by capital letter Y. Multiply the corresponding entries of these two columns. Get the value of capital letter X into Y. And add all these values, you get summation XY, which is 360. Using these values of sums, you can write the equation of the regression line. Regression line of y on x is capital letter y equal to summation xy divided by summation x square into x. Summation xy is a 360 divided by 204 into x. In this, capital letter y means small letter y minus 15 and capital letter y is x is small letter x minus 7. So this is the regression line of y. But in the later part, you are asked to find the coefficient of correlation using the equation of the regression line. To find the coefficient of the correlation using the equation of the regression lines, we use the formula r is equal to plus or minus bxy into byx. So from this equation itself, we can identify what is byx. From the regression line of y, we can identify what is byx. So compare this equation with the general form of the equation of the regression line of y, that is y minus y bar equal to byx into x minus x bar. And now you can see what comes in place of byx. Byx is 1.7647. In the same way, using the second equation, write the regression line of x on y. Capital letter x is equal to summation xy divided by summation y square into y. Substituting the value of summation xy and summation y square, 360 and 818, we gain the regression line of x, where capital letter x is x minus 7, capital letter y is y minus 15, and 360 divided by 818 means 0.4401. Compare this equation with the regression line of x, which is x minus x bar equal to bxy into y minus y bar. So comparing these two equations, you can gain the value of bxy, which is 0.4401. So knowing both bxy and byx, now you can calculate the coefficient of correlation r. Since both are positive, we take r as positive. So r will be plus root of byx into bxy. Substituting bxy and byx, we get r as 0.8813. So this is the answer for the first question. Second question, I mean question number 5. Second question of this slide, or it is question number 5. If 8x minus 10y plus 66 is equal to 0 and 40x minus 18y equal to 214, are the two regression lines. Find the mean of x's and y's, means x bar and y bar. Correlation coefficient, means r. Also find sigma y, the standard deviation of y, if sigma x is equal to 3. So here the equation of the regression lines are given. One is the regression line of y, another one is regression line of x. Using this regression lines, you have to find x bar, y bar, r. See the two general form of equation of the regression lines. Y minus y bar is equal to byx into x minus x bar. And x minus x bar is equal to bxy into y minus y bar. In these two equations, if you put x as x bar and y as y bar, both equations are satisfied. Which means x bar and y bar satisfies these two equations. So both the lines passes through that point x bar y bar. In other words, x bar y bar is the point of intersection of the two regression lines. So whenever from the regression lines we need x bar and y bar, it is enough if you calculate the point of intersection of the two regression lines. So here the two regression lines are given. We are asked to find x bar and y bar. So we need to find their point of intersection. So the first equation, you can write it as 8x minus 10y equal to minus 66. Second equation, you can write it as 40x minus 18y equal to 214. Both in the same form. Terms containing x and y on the left side, constant term on the right sides. Now you can solve these two equations using the calculator and find x, y. Without calculator, if you need that x and y, then first equation you can multiply by 5 and from that you can subtract the second equation. First equation multiplied by 5 gives 40x minus 50y equal to minus 330. Second equation 40x minus 18y equal to 214. Subtracting these two equations, 40x gets cancelled. So it will be minus 32y equal to minus 544. From this we get y as equal to 17. Put y as equal to 17 in the first equation or in the second equation, we get x. So if we use the first equation, put y equal to 17 in the first equation, on calculation we get x as equal to 13. So point of intersection is 13 and 17, which is x bar and y bar. So from the two regression lines, x bar and y bar are calculated. Next is to find the coefficient of correlation r. From the regression line, to get the coefficient of correlation, we use the formula r is equal to plus or minus root of byx into bxy. So to find this byx and bxy, among the two equation, one equation you have to take it as regression line of y, another equation you have to take it as regression line of x. By taking one equation as regression line of y and another equation as regression line of x, from these two equations we identify byx and bxy. Remember that byx and bxy should be of the same sign, either both positive or both negative. If they are of opposite sign, then interchange the equations. The equation which you had taken as a regression line of y, take it as a regression line of x. And the other equation which you had taken it as regression line of x, you take it as a regression line of y. So here, if I take the first equation as a regression line of y, which is 8x plus, which we can be written as 8x plus 66 is equal to 10y, first equation. From that I can write y dividing by 10. Y as 0.8x plus 6.6. Now the coefficient of x in this equation is 0.8. Compare this equation with the general equation of the regression line of y. And in that, y minus y bar is equal to byx into x minus x bar. Coefficient of x is byx. So comparing these two equations, we get byx as equal to 0.8. Similarly, second equation, you take it as a regression line of x. So we'll write what is x from this. Equation is 40x is equal to 18y plus 214. From that, dividing by 40, I get x as equal to 0.45y plus 5.35. Now compare this equation with the general equation of the regression line of x, that is x minus x bar is equal to bxy into y minus y bar. Here the coefficient of y in the right side is bxy, and in the equation which you are calculating, the coefficient of y in the right side is 0.45. So comparing these two equations, we get bxy as equal to 0.45. Both bxy and byx are positive, so r must be positive. So coefficient of correlation r will be plus root of byx into bxy. Substituting the value of byx and bxy, we get r as equal to 0.6. Now in the last part, you are asked to calculate sigma y using the value of sigma x. So sigma x is given in the question, r is already calculated, we need sigma y. So the formula involving r, sigma x and sigma y is either the formula of bxy or byx. So whenever we have r and one of the standard deviation, to find the other standard deviation, we can use the formula of bxy or byx. Here byx is 0.8 and the formula for byx is r into sigma y divided by sigma x. Substituting the value of r and sigma x, we get 0.2 into sigma y as equal to 0.8. Therefore sigma y will be 0.8 divided by 0.2 or equal to 4. Answer for the second question. Means fifth question. More questions we'll see in the next week.